Hello guys, this is me, Sasho, with another video, and I will try to make it this one as short as possible. So I'm pretty sure most of you already know about this ability to increase your FPS in Ghost Recon Phantoms with higher than 60, which 160 is the capped FPS for this game, but there is a trick enabling you to make higher FPS than 60. Some people already can achieve actually like more than 120 FPS in a game, even 144. So basically for me it does not work that way, and for other people as well does not are able to achieve so many frames, but still having more than 60, like between 60 and 71 constantly in the game, like having 65 or just 71 or maybe 80, it still makes differences. The game is much more flawless and much more smooth. The aiming is more easy, and the mouse control is much more easy. Actually, the feeling of the gameplay is kind of very different, and you feel that you can move and aim very easy. So okay, I will stop speaking bullshit and start with the important stuff. So as you can see right now on my right corner in game, I have like 86 FPS, 88. It's variable, it's not constant, but keep in mind that in my case it's very different. So first of all, I'll show the trick, the things that you have to do, and I'll talk about the differences between the computer configuration that might be in different people would have a different experience with this trick. So the simple way that actually is not the simple, the very important thing right now is that to make this trick, to be able to get the highest FPS, actually you need a gaming monitor. So without having a gaming monitor, you are not able to get higher than 60 FPS. Or if you don't have a gaming monitor, maybe if you have a standard monitor with a higher hertz, like higher than 60 hertz refresh rate, like there is a standard monitor with 75 hertz of refresh rate. So 75 is still something, and it still make differences to get 75 FPS in game. So basically you have to start with this, that if you don't have such a monitor, you will not be able to make this trick. So okay, first of all, you have to talk about this later, about the arrow time. Anyway, first of all, you have to go in the in-game settings and you have to select windowed mode. Then you have to enable VSync if you didn't do this yet. So to get the highest than 60 FPS in a game, you need to play in windowed mode and you have to enable VSync. So there is a tricky way that maybe if once you did this, once you set up in windowed mode and enable VSync, you still, if you still don't have this more than 60 FPS in the game, maybe you can try this to disable the IR window stem, which could be done simply by, okay, let me close this window open for you, by simply press the right mouse button on your desktop and then go to the personalize, and after that, as you can see, I've already selected the Windows Classic theme, which is by default remove The Aerotem. This is the Aerotem. I want it. I would not select it right now for the video purpose, but by default Windows 7 is installed with Aerotem if you have a decent PC, just in most cases. Otherwise, it will become with Windows 7 Basic. But so in my case, to have a highest FPS, maybe this would be the case for some of you with a gaming monitor, but with a different PC configuration, you have to disable the Aerotem of Windows 7 and just simply go down and press the Windows Classic Tem. This is the very easy, fast and simply way to do this. So for me, I have another issue because I'm having a dual monitor. So when I play the game to having a highest FPS, I have to turn off my monitor, and then I have to play on a single monitor. So I have to move everything on my single desktop on the first one. Also, as well, I have a capture card, so I have to unplug my cable, which I'm using to record from my video card directly to my capture card. So I have to unplug. So this is only in my case. Maybe for some of you won't be the same case. Maybe it would be a different. Maybe you would not have that issue. So I have to turn off my second monitor, and I have to unplug the capture card cable from my video card. And there was another trick that so to make sure that your monitor is actually running on highest hertz refresh rate, so simply can do again by opening the menu on your desktop, right mouse button, then go to the screen resolution. Just simply press this advanced settings, then select the tab, the monitor tab, and as you can see, I already have a screen refresh rate of 144. Of course, I can set up with a different refresh rate. So the standard refresh rate is 60 hertz, but here is I don't have in my list because my monitor does not support. 75 is also a standard, and it's coming with some of the newest model of monitors. So as I said, if you don't have a gaming monitor, which one is mine, you can try if you have a 75 hertz this trick. So the simple way, as I said, in game you have to set up window mode and enable VSync, and then maybe in some cases you just have to you have to disable the Aerotem. Just go to the Windows Classic Tem, and that's all. So let me just so unfortunately, so as you can see, okay, I have 70, 69, so. So, because I'm right now recording with OBS, I can't get right now more than 100. I can get actually more than 75, 77. As you can see in my upright corner, is still variable. It's not constant. But if I stop recording, automatically I will go to above 100, like 130 FPS in game. But for my cases, when I'm playing in match, it doesn't matter where I'm streaming or I'm recording, I can't achieve more than 75 frames, 71 frame FPS in a match. So in a lobby I have like 130 and even 140, but when I'm in a match I have no more than 71. So this is in my cases, in my case, in with my PC configuration. So maybe in your PC setup would be different. So I hope you enjoy. I hope you found this video useful, and maybe you can get this highest FPS. So stay tuned with my YouTube channel, and thanks for watching, guys.